the rage is not really to blame. So I'll remove the cause. But not the symptom. Well, welcome back to the second half of the shit house. Maybe not again. We've got lots of people in. Anybody in from Plek? Yeah! For those people from Plek, I'd just like to say good evening, good evening, and just evening. Can you say it in English? We don't speak fucking thick round here, it's right. Right, it ain't lovely, yes, it is Halloween! Yeah! I love fucking Halloween, that's where all the gay men put the willies up here. And all the straight men, they dress up as vampires and they want to suck you off. I'll tell you what, when you take your top off, right, and you've got a towel wrench when you come out the bath, I bet you think you've got fucking boils on your knee, don't you? And I was lying on the couch, right, I lifted my arm and just scratched the back of my head, my right cheek went and fell on the floor. The doctor went, "Ah!" I swear the fucking hell's the matter with you. He says, "Me tick your tits." That's what's the matter with my fucking tits. This is what he left, it's a C cup, it's the other fuckers on the floor. I said, "Well, I can't help that." I said, "That's my husband. He's got this fetish. He likes to play around with my nipples. He likes to grab them and tweak them." Then he gets them between his teeth and goes, "The doctor says I'll do that to my wife, her tits are like that." I said, "No, but we sleep in fucking bunk beds." Then as you can see, my dentist, I've got this lovely new dentist called Paul McCracken. He said, "Come in, sit down and open wide." So I did. He says, "Now your mouth." He says, "You had oral sex last night, didn't you?" I went, "Oh my God, I haven't got a pubic hair in my teeth, have I?" He says, "No, you've got a bit of shit on the end of your nose."
Your hands on your hips.
Give me the music, God.
Thank you. Come on.